There have been significant changes over the past 5 years. As we have improved our hormonal therapies, we've discovered, and perhaps we should have expected, but it's come as a surprise to a lot of us, that by more dramatically, more accurately, and more strongly targeting testosterone and its receptor called the androgen receptor, we can induce remissions even in men whose disease is growing through our low level of testosterone state. And the hormonal therapies just over the past 5 years have been improving. We have two terrific drugs that are now FDA approved that both deny the cell's testosterone in a more dramatic way. We have another medicine that blocks the androgen receptor itself in a way we've never been able to do before. And we've proven that men are living longer as a result of these drugs. And there are more drugs in clinical trial that may be even better than the current generation. So that's been a really exciting development. The next exciting development in prostate cancer will be immunotherapy. And we're particularly excited about immunotherapy because it makes a lot of sense. One reason why cancer has been so difficult to get our arms around once it metastasizes is that it is free to evolve. And one of the special things about the immune system is that it can evolve along with the cancer. If we can teach the immune system to fight the cancer cells and fight the cancer cells as the cancer cells are changing. And there has been incredible progress in certain cancers such as melanoma, now in my area of expertise, renal cell carcinoma and bladder cancer. And it's a matter of time before we figure out how to use the immune system to fight prostate cancer.